shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger.
Yeah. felt it soon. A will of the weary world beats oasis, while yonder makes a new and glorious home. Fall on your knees, oh, hear the angel voices. For night, oh, night, when Christ was sworn.
Now, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem in the days of Herod the king, wise men came from the east to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him." And when they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy.
Thank you.
And the star, which they had seen in the east, went before them until it came and stood over where the little child was. And when they had come into the house, they saw the young child with his mother Mary, and they fell down and worshipped him. And they offered their treasures and presented gifts to him, gold and frankincense and myrrh.
Thank you.
he was born in an obscure village, the child of a peasant woman. He grew up in still another village, where he worked in a carpenter shop until he was 30. Then, for 3 years, he was an itinerant preacher. He never wrote a book. He never held an office. He never had a family or owned a house. He didn't go to college. He never visited a big city. He never traveled 200 miles from the place where he was born. He did none of the things one usually associates with greatness. He had no credentials but himself. He was only 33 when the tide of public opinion turned against him. His friends ran away. He was turned over to his enemies and went through the mockery of a trial. He was nailed to a cross between two thieves. While he was dying, his executioners gambled for his clothing, the only property he had on earth. When he was dead, he was laid in a borrowed grave through the pity of a friend. 20 centuries have come and gone, and today he is considered by many to be the central figure of the human race and the leader of mankind's progress. All the armies that ever marched, all the navies that ever sailed, all the parliaments that ever sat, all the kings that ever reigned together have now affected the life of man on this earth. Thank you. Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God.